Hey there, this is Tracy, health coach and personal trainer and founder of HighEnergyGirl.com. And in today's video, we are going to talk about weightlifting for women. Why you need to do it, how to get started, and what is it going to do for your figure? First off, why do you need to do it? Well, here's the deal. You are either going to age stronger or age weaker. Nothing stays static. So I would like to see you age stronger because I'm telling you, I just moved my parents into a senior facility and watching my mom decay the way she is keeping my commitment to healthy food and healthy lifestyle like 100% because on my genes, both my parents have horrible genetics. But because we are noticing what gene expression means is that you can change your genes by your practice, okay? So, like I said, age stronger or age weaker. What are you going to choose? Now, when I see people in my workout classes, in my spin classes, I used to teach Zumba. Oh my God, that was so fun. Imagine that you're like 22 years old and you're busting a move on the dance floor like you really wish you could without being embarrassed. Anyway, I digress. But it's really important because all these people who do chronic cardio, first of all, your body adapts to it. Second of all, your body doesn't really change shape because biceps are made in the gym and abs are made in the kitchen. So what I notice is that people just keep coming to these classes over and over and over and their bodies aren't changing. Now, if you want to find a really easy way to get started, what I recommend is doing it 2 days a week, your full body workout. No need to start off with anything complicated because I still do a 2 day a week full body workout. So what you're gonna wanna do is train all the major body groups. So your legs, your glutes, that's your booty back there. Chest, back, shoulders, arms, and core, okay? You can start off just by doing 3 sets per body part. That means three exercises, okay? So 1 exercise, 3 times. So it's 1 exercise with 3 sets, and then you do your weights. Now you wanna make sure you go slower than you think you should. Don't watch the people around you because chances are they're going too fast. It's really important to go slow. And another thing I do, because if you're like me, you're in busy land, I superset, meaning I'll do 1 body part and then the other body part. So say I'll do shoulders and biceps, and then I'll do another shoulders and then another biceps. That's called supersetting. So you rest one muscle while you train another, and that will keep your efficiency up in the gym and you'll get done in a faster time. It will also keep your heart rate up, and it's a really good practice. Now, what is it gonna do to your body? Well, first of all, I always ask, what weighs more, 1 pound of muscle or 1 pound of fat? What's your answer? Hopefully you said they both weigh the same, 1 pound. But the best thing is that the muscle takes up less space in your clothes, all right? So you know what a muffin top is, right? Well, if you have muscle right there, it's not going to be a muffin top. Now, you can take 2 people, okay? They are the same height. So these 2 women, they're both exactly the same height and exactly the same weight. One of them is an athlete and spends time in the gym and is very lean. And the other one is like, she just does chronic cardio. She doesn't do any lifting. So their body compositions and appearance are gonna be completely different, okay? One of them might be like a size 6 and the other one might be like a size 8 because one is doing her workouts and lifting weights and the other one is not. So this one's gonna have a lower body fat percentage and this one's going to have a higher body fat percentage. And another reason you wanna do this is because it is going to boost your metabolism. Now your metabolism is the calories that you burn at rest. That's your basal metabolic rate, is that the calories that your body does without adding any extra exercise. So the more muscle mass you have on the body, the more you can eat without gaining fat. How cool is that? So we all want to have lots of muscle on our body. Now, the really cool thing is with a ketogenic diet, it is what's called muscle sparing. That means that your body is not burning muscle to get fuel because it likes to burn fat instead. It likes to burn ketones instead. If you're a carb burner, a glucose burner, then when you don't have enough carbs in your body because say you're not eating or you're cutting your calories, guess what happens? Your body is going to convert your muscle into glucose instead, okay? We don't want that. That's called gluconeogenesis, and that is your body's taking your muscle and converting it into glucose to be used for fuel. Okay, so those are three topics that I wanted to cover really quick about weightlifting for women. Please comment below, ask any questions you have. This was just a really high level overview, and next video on fitness, we will dive deeper into each one of the topics. And then, hey, maybe we'll add a little bit more. So be sure to click the notifications button so you don't miss any video in our series that we're working on, because our High Energy Reset program covers all these juicy details. And be sure to pay attention, because we are going to be releasing new information very, very often. You don't want to miss a beat. So we'll see you on the next video.